this is Debbie Gibson, and you are watching The Music Scene.
Hey, everybody, this is Darren Frommel with The Music Scene at the 2011 Entertainment and Choice Awards. We're looking forward to seeing who we get on the red carpet, so stay tuned. Doug, so what's it like to put on this event?
It's a lot of pressure, man, but it's so much fun. I mean, everyone's come together. The community's just been so wonderful, and all the entertainment, and actually, come here. And we have just so many people here, and it's just it's a wonderful, wonderful time, and it's just exciting, you know? So,
I mean, your family is known throughout the world. What's it like for you to be here to put this first annual, you know, and have all these people show up?
Well, you know, it feels great. You know, everyone has come together. Everyone's worked so hard, and it's about time we started giving recognition where recognition is due to Utah, to all the talent, to all the people that give to this state. You know, they film here, movies all the time. They do great music here. They have great broadcasting. We have great symphony, great NBA team, and, you know, soccer team. It's a great place to be. So, you know, this is the right place, man. Quoting Brigham Young.
I'm going to call you a musical icon. Is that okay?
You call me old.
No. Fabulous is what I'm calling you.
So,
so what brings you here to this award ceremony?
Well, guys, speaking of musical icons, I'm very close with the Osmond family, and I did the tour of Joseph with 7 of the 8 of Alan's boys. So I became like the adopted sister. I was on the road with them for 9 months. So when I heard that they were honoring Alan tonight, I really wanted to be here. And just having visited here a bit, and being here tonight, it's obvious that Utah has become a huge entertainment, sports, broadcasting capital. We always think New York and LA. But obviously, Utah's kind of you know, I don't want to say it's the best kept secret, but kind of. I mean, it's really, really great that there's an event of this magnitude to celebrate all the great talents that come out of Utah.
So what are you up to musically?
I'm actually working on a new album, and I'm doing Good Morning America's concert series this summer, and I'm doing some tour dates with Tiffany, my arch nemesis from the 80s.
And you just did the movie, too.
We did the crazy sci-fi movie and had a big Dynasty-esque cat fight in the movie, and we're chased by giant critters. So life's pretty good. What's cool about it is, you know, there was obviously, like, style-wise, a crossover for us in the 80s, but she's gone completely into her country rock genre now, and I'm in my, like, dance pop mode and ballads at the piano, so there's going to be a lot of versatility in the evening, and we don't have a date on the books yet for Utah, so bring us here. We'd love to come.
Thank you so much, Debbie. So this is your first time in Utah?
You know what? It's my absolute first time in Utah, and I was so upset the first couple days. Look at the weather. What's going on? I mean, it's like being back home in Switzerland. It's like rainy and cloudy, but it was so nice. Just about 2 or 3 hours ago, I was in my hotel. I look out the window, and I see the sky opening, the sun coming out, and I saw the mountains and the snow. Nice. Gorgeous. What a beautiful place you guys have here.
You're known for The Matrix Reloaded. Since you think so highly of Utah now and everything, would you like to do a film here?
You know, it's actually funny. The last couple of days, I'm driving around and I'm telling my friends here, I'm like, you should really try to bring more films to Utah. I've directed a film, a short film called Fetch, put a little plug, and I'm actually in the process to turn it into a feature film, and I'm talking to people here actually to maybe we can do it here. Who knows, you know?
Your job here tonight is the host. So, a little nervous?
You know, I'm not nervous. I've never done this before. I'm not a host, I'm an actor. I'm an action actor. And I said to everybody when they asked me, I'm like, guys, I'm an action actor. Are you sure you want me to do comedy? And they're like, yeah, you're funny, just come on, just do it. So when I got the script, I'm like, looking at the jokes, I'm not getting the jokes. So they actually have to explain me the jokes. So that's going to be funny, I think. But you know what? They told me, Daniel, it's all family. Let's just have a good time. We'll see what happens. I'm excited, though.
Hi, Dina Marie. How are you tonight?
I'm good. I'm excited. This is crazy, right?
Yeah.
It's a little bit overwhelming.
And you're a nominee tonight for the Future Award? And David Archuleta is presenting that. What's that like?
Well, I'm hoping that he'll sing it to me if I win, or that he'll sing it no matter what.
if Miss Honeybee was here right now, what would she say about this?
She would say, oh my gosh, I'm so excited, and I'm in a pink dress as puffy like a cupcake. But she's not here tonight.
You're big time on YouTube, right? You're Dina Show, Woman of a Thousand Faces, right? What's that like? You have like 43,000 subscribers. What's that like?
It's bizarre. It's a blessing and a curse, really. It's funny when people ask me if it's really me in all of my videos, or they say, where do you find all of these actresses? And it's me, it's all me. I try and pride myself on always being a master of disguise. I'm always changing my look, whether it's glamorous or the opposite of glamorous. I love coming up with new characters and just being silly and, yeah, putting myself out there. I'm not afraid to be embarrassed, which is key if you're gonna put yourself on YouTube.
What do you think about this amazing first annual Utah Entertainment and Choice Awards?
I think it's incredible. I hope it's a sign of things to come. I mean, I think more and more Utah's being recognized as, you know, a real city and having a lot going on. A lot of movies are being filmed here. I think it's all very positive. I hope it's, yeah, a sign of things to come. I'd like to see how it goes tonight and how they build on it year after year. I mean, already looking around tonight at the turnout and the red carpet and how everything has been set up, it's pretty amazing for Salt Lake.
So you are the current reigning Miss Utah USA. What is that like for people who don't know what that's like?
It's incredible. It's completely changed my life. I'm busy every second, and I'm just getting ready for the Miss USA pageant on June 19th, so I'm just so excited.
So what do you think of this first annual award ceremony, the Utah Entertainment and Choice Awards?
Yeah, I think it's incredible. I think it's about time. We have some very talented people here. We need to start awarding them for all they do. So I'm excited to be a part of it and be able to give an award out tonight.
Now, have you done acting also?
A little bit. I've done modeling probably my whole life, so a little bit of commercial acting, performing, the arts. I used to dance, so it just makes sense that I'm here, so I'm excited.
Are you looking forward to seeing anybody tonight?
Well, I just met David Archuleta, so that's off my list.
Thank you. Have a great evening.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, and good luck.
Thank you.
In broadcasting for over 40 years, what's it like to have this award show here in Utah?
You know, I think it's probably long overdue. I'm a little bit in awe here right now. I'm trying to still get my bearings on exactly what's going on and how it all came about and all, but I was contacted by the Osmonds to be a part of it. I've known them, the family, for a long time, and I think this is exciting for the state of Utah. Maybe we can get our feet wet again in the entertainment industry and a little bit more than in the past. So I'm looking forward to tonight and hopefully the years to come, the same event. So.
Thank you so much, Mr. Norris.
Thank you. It's a pleasure. Thank you.
Marshall Moore, the head of the Utah Film Commission. What's it like for you to see this first annual Entertainment and Choice Awards here in Utah?
Well, I'm glad these guys took a chance to do it and actually made it happen. I'd heard about it a few months ago, and I said, boy, if you can pull this off and then continue to pull it off year after year, this will be a kind of a signature event for the state of Utah. And I think you'll see it continue to expand and grow based on what happens tonight.
So what's next for film in Utah?
Well, the good news is we just increased our incentive package. Governor, legislature were on board to go from a 20% incentive to a 25%, which will help us to continue to be competitive with other states for attracting films here. And we also want to nurture our in-state film industry as well, and they can also take advantage of our incentive program. So what's next is really, we hope, a continuous pipeline of production coming through the state and employing our people and using our resources.
Now, up till now, about, can you guesstimate how many projects have been done here in Utah since the Film Commission's been around?
Well, you know, I don't have to guess because we do chart that kind of thing. So there's over 900. I mean, you know, 900 give or take a few that we know about. Now, beyond that, I'm sure there's many more that haven't been documented. But yes, in terms of production that we know about and the list that we keep, about 900 feature films and television movies have been shot in the state, and countless commercials, of course.
Thank you, Marshall.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Buy or lease a new Audi and we'll make your first payment up to $1,000 during the Season of Audi event now at Strong Audi.